السلام عليكم. Which methodology do you recommend to study Shafi'i fiqh? What do we study after Matn Abi Shuja? First of all, I don't consider myself a sheikh and I really don't find it befitting. So I just wanted to put that out there, inshallah ta'ala. So don't call me sheikh, inshallah. The second thing, inshallah ta'ala, is fiqh al-Shafi'i, the matn that generally a person should start with, generally say speaking, is Matn Abi Shuja'. And some scholars, they say, no, you can start with Safinatul Najah, it's smaller, it's better. So let's take that opinion for now. Do Safinatul Najah, and then after that, do Matn Abi Shuja'. Once you finish Matn Abi Shuja', go for Yaqutun Nafis, and then after that, do the Zubad Ibn Raslan, and then after that, do the Umdatul Salik wa Uddatul Nasik Ibn Naqib al-Misri, and then after that, do the Minhaj of Imam al-Nawawi. Once you do those, inshallah ta'ala, you'll be grounded and have a good understanding of the fiqh of the madhab of Imam al-Shafi'i. And if you want to memorize, then memorize the Zubad ibn Raslan. It's 1,000 lines, but it's very good. Some people, they memorize the Imriti's Nadhm of Matn Abi Shuja', which is also 1,000. I would say don't do that. If you're going to memorize, it's better to memorize the Zubad ibn Raslan, and there are many reasons why I think so. But that's another discussion for another day.